How you doing?
What's happening? We got street stars.
Okay, so first and foremost, how's your day been today?
Today, it's been alright, you know. It's been a bit hectic, but the day in the life of Cookie, I suppose.
I see a bit of Cavassier in the corner as well.
Yeah, do you know what? I'm not drinking it though.
So what's that?
This is tropical juice.
Yeah, that's what they all say.
It's a lie.
This is tropical juice.
I see him pour it as well.
It's a tropical juice, man.
All right. So we get to the music. So how long have you been doing music then?
How long? It's been a while, man. Probably about 6 years now.
6 years?
Yeah.
So you should be a pro at it by now, yeah?
Yeah, I'd say I'm a pro, yeah.
Gotta see that mainstream money soon.
I'm trying, man. I'm trying, yeah.
Don't forget your people, yeah?
No.
Don't forget the people that age.
Who's not?
Right. So tell us about your recent collaboration and your recent single.
My recent which collaboration are you talking about?
The one for your new single called.
Oh, my new one. Oh, no, you know what? That wasn't a single. Like, what that was just a track of my EP.
Okay, so that's not going to be pushed.
It's going to be pushed, but not as much as my proper single. Because what it was just a track of my EP that we got good feedback from. So we thought we'd do a video for it and then see how it goes. It's going on TV and all that, but we're not going to push it as much as how we're going to push my debut single. So.
Which is?
It's called Best of Me and it's featuring Darren B.
Okay.
Yeah, but no one ain't heard it yet, so.
Are we gonna get an exclusive?
Yeah?
That's a yeah.
Possibly. But yeah.
So what about, have you got anybody in mind that you would like to collaborate with?
What, UK wise?
Yeah. Keep it UK.
I mean, obviously. To be honest, everyone really, everyone's at the peak of their game, so.
Yeah.
Every collaboration's been good. That I've heard so far, so working with anyone would be good. Everyone from the UK, anyway.
Anyone kind of stepped on my lap, like my question. Because I was going to ask you, a lot of people are doing this music thing. Like, who are you rating the most? Who would you like to work with? Who do you think, obviously, is doing the best?
Who am I rating the most?
Yeah.
The thing with me now is I rate people in the game, but for different things. So, for example, someone like I like Dot Rotten, and not because. I think he's the best spitter or something like that.
I've heard
like his projects and his projects are put together good. So I rate him for that. I rate him for that. But then someone like Skepta, I rate him for going as far as he's gone for whilst being independent. So like there's different things, you know what I'm saying? Then I rate people like Black, obviously, people like Bloodline, they're doing their thing, like they're causing massive problems in the game. Like I rate people for different things, so everyone's just doing their thing. There's no one that I can say, yeah, that's the person, he's the guy. Like, there's no one that I can really say that about, so.
Okay, so obviously there's loads of F64s on Grand Daily.
Mm.
But I heard there was a little issue with SB and you, of you doing your
F64. Mm. To be honest,
please address
if I'm being 100% honest, I can't even tell you what the issue is. I've never met SB, I've never spoke to him on the phone. Like, basically, just. I'm in the scene like everyone else in it, so all the avenues that everyone else goes down, I have to go down them as well.
Yeah.
In a way. So everyone done their F64. As a matter of fact, everyone hadn't even done their F64s yet. There was only a few people that had done it. I saw it from earlier and then I messaged him and I just said like, oh, can I do one? And at first he was like, yeah, you can do one, yeah, I'll holler at you, blah, 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 I'm a bit busy now. And obviously I accept that because we're all busy. And then like weeks went past, he never hollered. Then I was like, oh, SB, like when do you still want to do the F64? Sorry. And then he was like, yeah, that's cool. Then to cut a long story short, I hollered at him like, you might as well say a million times, and then he just kept like, yeah, next time. So it got to the point where it's like, how many times can you ask someone to do something
before you feel like, he just
doesn't want me to do it? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then like it's a personal problem or.
Just like,
I don't know. I really don't know. But what it is,
busy.
he could just possibly be busy, but like everyone else in the scene has done one, so you got me.
So you're just gonna look at it more like it's personal then.
Yeah, I'm not gonna say it's personal because I've never met him on a personal. I've never seen him. So you know what I mean? So, but what made me think that there might be something personal is because someone from my management team messaged him and he was like, "Oh, how come everyone else has done the F64 and Cookie ain't?" And then he was like, "Oh, you're just making the situation worse." So then we was like, rah, situation. But as I said, I still spoke to him, so I don't know. But SB, no problem. I ain't got no problem with anyone, man. I'm just on a humble. positive energy vibe.
Positive energy.
F64 isn't the only way to go places, so I'm just working with the resources that I've got in. So
exactly. So what's your like aspirations as an artist? Where do you like aim to be? Where can you see yourself in like
in a couple of years?
Right now, I want to set my goals high, but I don't want to say next year I'm going to be number one. Da 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 da. Like I'm just trying to go as far as I can.
But then don't be scared to say that either. Like,
No.
To say I want to be number one. Yeah.
Yeah. I would love to be
number one next year.
Yeah. Written that Team Cookie. But you know what it is, yeah? I would love to be number one, but as I said earlier, like you can't go to a studio and say this tune's gonna be a number one tune. Do you know what I mean? You just have to work.
Well, every song you make, like not everybody's gonna like what you're doing. You're gonna have the people that don't like it because that's just how it is. But you need to have the people that don't like it as well because you always need to get them comments.
Don't forget the haters are the ones that are buying your singles. They're the ones that are actually going out.
They're the ones that talk about it the most.
They're the ones that comment.
So they're the ones that actually make your song known because they'll talk about it the most.
And they'll be like, have you heard Cookie single?
No, I haven't. Oh, yeah. Well, listen to it.
That's like an extra view.
It's good. I think it's like, you listen to it? And then it's like 50 million.
True.
Just saying.
Yeah, no, you're right.
That's just our opinion, you know.
You're right.
You know, there's a Twitter like, you know, just saying.
No, you're right. So basically, yeah, I'm just making as much music as I can, making as much different music as I can, so like different genres and stuff, and then just see how it goes, man.
I've been getting
a good response since I started, because I stopped doing music for a while, and then I came back, and I've been getting a good response since I come back, so I'm just working with it, really.
What do you think of the scene since you've come back? What's the change?
The change? I can't really say everyone, but people are more business-minded about it now, because obviously, before, we was just literally just writing lyrics. Well, when I first started doing music, it was just write a lyric, go radio, spit the lyric, get a wheel up, and that's it. You was happy. You didn't even ever think about money. Do you know what I mean? It was just, hopefully, when you walk down the street, a girl would say, that's Cookie. That was the most, you know what I'm saying? That was really what it was about, yeah?
That's all we cared about.
We love the girl.
Yeah, I'm saying, but now we come back and like people are doing things properly. Like everyone's got their business sorted. People are making it into a brand.
Mm-hmm.
And it's good, man. Like, it seems more positive than it was before.
It's more positive. I was going to say, do you think it's more crap now that money's got involved?
Nah, not at all. I wouldn't say that at all. I'd say it's more positive. I've noticed people are working together more. Like, before, the UK hip-hop scene and the grime scene was like totally, never, ever, ever, hardly ever hear any like mixture. Now it's like one scene, really.
Yeah.
Like you'll hear people on tunes with, you'll hear like grime artists on tunes with UK hip hop artists and stuff like that. We all just work together now. So it's better, it's positive, and it's bigger. That makes the team bigger as well. So, yeah, man.
Okay, so 2:10.
2:10 what?
2:10, where are you taking 2:10? What should we be looking out for in 2:10?
I've got the single coming out. We're gonna push that. We're hoping to make some noise with that.
Okay.
A few more videos. Another project. I'm putting out a free EP soon in the next few weeks.
Just for
downloads and stuff. Just consistent work, man. That's it. By the end of the year, I want to be able to say, look back. Like New Year's. This is what my motto is. Yeah. New Year's, you should have something to celebrate. People go out on New Year's and they just celebrate that they had a rubbish year. Like, that's rubbish. I want to go out on New Year's and say, the reason why I'm celebrating is because I've done this, that, da, 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 and I can look back and be happy at how the year went, you know what I'm saying? So that's my aim. So I want to be able to celebrate on New Year's, pour drinks for a reason, not just rave for the sake. Yeah, do you know what I mean? So that's it, man.
Alright then, so 2:10, watch out for Cookie New Year's Eve.
Yeah.
We'll all be popping champagne, obviously, so.
That's it.